Anand, welcome to FC Director's Cut. We are so happy to sit down and talk to you. I think your journey has been so interesting. I feel like in the last, what, about 8 years since Tanu Weds Manu?
Yeah.
2011. Yes. You've like created the Aanand L Rai genre. Okay. It's like, you know, this universe of sort of familiar, relatable people who are invariably small town, middle class. But I almost feel like I know an Aanand Rai character when I see one. Okay, how ye Aanand Rai character? Haan, ye iska ho sakta. How has this evolved?
No, first thing first, मुझे अभी भी ये लगता है that I'll be caught someday and say, अरे तेरे को direction नहीं आती.
क्यों? You
know? Trust me, what I have done till now is what I am, and I have never tried to do something out of box. For me, all these stories are somewhere around me, and I always feel that jinko dekh ke hum bade hue hain, makers like Bimal Roy, Gurudutt, Raj Kapoor, they have brought in those stories which are that surprises you and say ki, it has got a great power to change the thought process of a person. I don't think I'm doing that. The only thing I'm doing is I'm staying honest to what I am in real life and what I know. I'm not pushing myself too much to create something which can make you think. Maybe yes, I am entertaining people. I'm trying to tell simple stories in an interesting way. But yeah, deep down, it's not a very filmmaker kind of thing I'm doing. So that's
what is a filmmaker thing? Meaning you're talking about craft?
No, I'm talking about the thinking man. When you see Satyakam, something happens to you. When you see Jagte Raho, something happens to you and you keep thinking about it. When you see Sujata or Bandini, there is a maker who's trying to tell you about your society, about the world, and he's somewhere making a statement. I'm not doing that. If you ask me, I'm not doing that. I'm enjoying. I'm just fulfilling my desire of putting out a story, you know. A little gutsy step was Ranjana, where I wanted to, again, it was just for me to understand as a director, how will I deal with death. So that was my, again, a very personal need, you can say. And yeah, so that's one reason I always feel that somewhere when it gets over, people will say, this is not direction. This is a very personal thing you have done till now.
So you're taking these stories, not from your life necessarily, but from the worlds you know.
The worlds I know. Means when people say that I'm good with small town, I feel that it's actually not small town, it's middle class. Hmm. A middle class in which I was born and brought up. And those were 70s, 80s, 90s.
You said you were a government colony ka bachcha.
Haan, main wo sare ghar ek jaise dikhte hain, you know. I'm really proud of it. I'm really proud of this one thing that I'm a middle class boy. But now I feel that middle class, where I belong, I've shifted to those small towns. I was born and brought up in Delhi. But now I feel that middle class has also changed. That real middle class is me is now. The stories which I am telling you and trying to bring out are now somewhere, it is in Lucknow, Kanpur, Haryana, Jalandhar. Right. So it is that middle class has shifted, that my middle class has shifted there. So people are telling me that I am making a small town film.
You work extensively with Himanshu Sharma.
Yeah.
What is this creative process like?
The process, if you ask me, is I'm in no hurry and he's lazy.
How does that work then?
I'm making it clear. I'm not lazy. I'm in no hurry.
Right.
And he's lazy.
You're a patient man.
I'm a patient man. And we really enjoy talking. So we do that. And somewhere, that is the process. talking. Give us food, we'll sit, we'll talk. Again, give us break. Again, give us food, we'll sit and talk. And somewhere in those talks, in those lazy moments, we come out with something ki yaar hame ye sunana hai. You know, whether it was Tanu, it's Manu or Ranjana or returns and now zero. Till now we feel that we have nothing to lose. So the process begins with ki kya ho jayega? At the most kya ho jayega?
Right.
So that is something I feel very, very happy about, that with whatever less or more we have, we are secured. We are secured and we are ready to tell a story. You have to be very secured when you tell a story. So I think that is our process.
So you sit, you talk, brainstorming hoti hai ki basic concept ye hai, and then he writes and he comes back to you.
He writes and comes back to me. It's not that ki hum logon ne char scene discuss ki and then he'll go back and work on it and then we'll move ahead. No. We sit, we talk about the world, we talk about the characters, and then he goes and comes back. And then whatever we feel.
But and you're brutal with each other? Matlab,
we are very, 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 very brutal with each other.
मतलब कोई रूटता नहीं है ऐसे
रूटता नहीं रूटते भी हैं हम लोग रूटते
लड़ाई होती
हैं हाँ पर नॉट टू एन एक्सटेंड जहाँ पे मुझे ये लगने लगे कि वी आर थिंकिंग वेरी डिफरेंटली इट्स नॉट दैट इवन व्हेन आई एम डायरेक्टिंग ही इज देयर उस पे वो भी रूटता है बट अगेन इट इज नॉट अबाउट यू नो
ही सेज कि ये ठीक नहीं था
हाँ मतलब अभी भी एट टाइम्स ही कम्स एंड टेल्स मी दैट रांझना का कुंदन अभी भी मेरे अंदर है आप यू हैव नॉट ब्रॉट इट ऑन द स्क्रीन द वे आई वॉज लुकिंग एट बट दैट्स फाइन दैट्स एंड ऑफ द डे इट हैज टू बी माय कुंदन यू गो एंड मेक योर ओन अगेन सो दिस इज हाउ वी आर एंड वी आर एंजॉयिंग द बेस्ट पार्ट इज दैट ये हमारे लिए है हमारा प्रोफेशन बट वी आर रियली रिलिशिंग इट This is, and we have not put it on a barometer ki isse hamare paas kitna aa raha hai and after this we will do and we'll reach there. We are not.
Wo sab nahi hai.
Haan, strategies nahi hai iske andar.
Bilkul nahi hai.
Bilkul nahi hai. Bilkul nahi hai. Somehow it has been working for us and it's a very organic process.
And with more success, there's not more insecurity?
Till now, no. There is a certain kind of pressure when I talk about zero. But then again, it is not a very professional thing. The pressure is of newness, which I always wanted to go through, you know. And I need that little nervousness in me, at the same time excitement in me to tell a story, which I think is, but there is no insecurity. There's definitely no insecurity. And I still feel I have nothing to lose.
You speak often about taking all pretense out of filmmaking. You know, in many of your interviews, you say, ki, I'm really honest to it. I take all. When you say pretense, what do you mean? What are you taking out?
Doing something for an effect. In the story or with your character, I'm literally concerned and I'm a little worried when while writing or while directing if even a small thought of ki yaar ye audience ko acha lagega aisa kar lete hain is something I feel that it's the point where you start cheating yourself. There's nothing like that. Either it is there or it is not there.
Right. Either it's organically in the story.
In the story, right. Or it is not there. So don't go for it. Let's do something. Audience will like it. Audience will like it if it is coming with that conviction. You can't do it for them.
Right.
You know. So that's what I say. There is I call that ki ye wala pretense nahi hona chahiye. Ki aisa karke dega is character ko na thoda. देख मजा आएगा वो है या नहीं है यू हैव टू ब्रिंग इट इन द कैरेक्टर इफ इट इज देयर देन यू डोंट हैव टू कुछ भी एक्सटर्नल मत लाओ डोंट ब्रिंग इट
यू आर आल्सो ऑफ कोर्स आल्सो प्रोड्यूसिंग फिल्म्स
या
यू नो putting your might behind small films with very big ideas, and you've got Happy Phir Bhaag Jayegi coming up, Manmarziyaan is going to release. You've got one film, Tumbar, at the Venice Film Festival. Manmarziyaan is going to Toronto Film Festival. Yeah. Amazing. I mean, as a producer, you've been so successful. How do you decide what to put your might behind?
It's been very simple for me. First of all, I feel that whatever has happened in last 5 years, even I'm surprised. But at the same time, falling in love with stories is getting stronger day by day, and falling in love with the makers also. When I say this, like when I'm working with Anurag now, I always feel that hum dono ki zarurat thi is waqt saath aana. There was something I wanted to learn from him. There was something which was there with me so that I can give it to him. So now I have started enjoying this thing along with this. And there is, again, when you say producer kind of thing, I don't treat myself as a producer. I feel that this is now my, if I have achieved this much with my films, this is my duty to get attached with a film like Newton. If I'm in this position for this only, this is my purpose. And I'm the best part is that I still don't know those bank books. What have they given me with returns?
You're not checking?
No, I'm not checking. The day I'll check, I won't be able to do Newton. I won't be able to do Nilbertisanat. I won't be able to, and I don't want. I'm happy. But trust me, I'm very happy. And again, what is coming to my rescue is that middle class boy who's very happy with ek sabzi, ek dal, do roti. I'm comfortable. So I don't need much. I don't understand cars, expensive cars. I know that four wheeler is important. So I have that. So I don't need to calculate. What is very important for me is that main ghar jata hoon aur mujhe neend bahut achhi aati. And after that, if I'm involved in these films, I am thankful to film like Newton or Mukkabaz or Manmarziyaan. Main nahi bana sakta ye. I'm now part of it, and I'm fortunate.
So, agar kahani pasand aayi, you're on board. You don't look at other things.
I don't. I really don't. And I always feel that this is a director's medium, and make stories, don't make setups. That's the crux of it. I really want to enjoy stories.
Yeah.
Don't get into that race of get an actor, then getting just a star. Get an actor for your film.
You know, let's talk about Zero, the most ambitious film of your career.
Yeah.
I read this interview, Anand, that you did in 2013, where you're talking about how you have to emotionally connect with your actors. And you said in that interview, saalon pehle, ki I feel I'll be able to connect with Shah Rukh. He'll understand what I'm saying without me having to be a director.
Yeah.
How did you know then that you could connect?
I had a strong feeling. And I was not
at
talking
this time
about
you had him. Met him? You knew him?
No.
Never
no,
met him?
No, no. I met him in 2015.
But you just knew that it would work?
I somewhere knew, you look at an actor, because I knew somewhere that jab bhi main inse milunga, there will be something which will gel with him. And it has happened. It has happened magically. And I'm not talking about a director-actor tuning or a bonding. I'm talking about one person to another person. I have learned a lot from him. Again, it's nothing professional about it, on a very personal level. And same way, I've enjoyed talking, expressing myself. And it's the same way he's there with me and making things very easier for me. Aur main bahut saari baatein karta hoon unke saath. And trust me, otherwise, agar hum dono aise nahi hote, Zero is really a tough film. But I am telling you, this is one of the finest journeys I have had till now, and I've really enjoyed. And this is how आई वुड हैव थॉट ऑफ कि जीरो ऐसी दिखनी चाहिए और ऐसी बननी चाहिए. फॉर दैट शाहरुख खान वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
बट यू न्यू इंस्टिंक्टिवली दिस इज एन एक्टर हु यू विल.
आई समवेयर न्यू एंड आई मुझे ये भी पता था कि आई विल बी एबल टू आई डोंट नो वेदर आई एम एबल टू कन्वर्ट दैट ऑन द स्क्रीन बट द रियल मैन इन साइड हिम आई कैन वेरी कॉन्फिडेंटली से आई नो हिम आई यू नो एंड एज एन एक्टर वॉट ही इज आस्किंग फॉर आई कैन रियली अंडरस्टैंड दैट.
बट इट्स इंटरेस्टिंग दिस relationship you have with your actors, because Dhanush also said ki the only reason he's in the Hindi film industry is because of you, that you saw him and you just insisted ki it has to be this man. How where does this conviction come from?
See, when we talk about Dhanush, yes, that was a director eyeing for an actor, because I needed somebody as a director, I needed somebody to understand the ordinariness of that character, and Dhanush is brilliant with that. A very confident, lovably arrogant actor, and I wanted somebody like him at that point. And then I decided ki it's not somebody like him, it's
him.
Him. And our first meeting where he said, I want to do this film but I don't know Hindi, and I said, that's not your problem, that's my problem. Tum Tamil mein bhi bol doge na, it'll work. But if you ask me now, he's not an actor for me. He's a younger brother to me. We share a brilliant relationship. And I feel very proud of this. And we as an industry, and especially actors, people say they are very selfish people. Or hamare liye bhi bola jata hai ki while you're making a film, you're a family. Once the film is over, it finishes off. And then another set of people move in and you fall in love all over again and you forget the, but it's not happening with me.
You hold on.
I hold on and I feel very proud of it. And I'm very emotional about it. Means if Dhanush is in town, that means he's at my place. I will never allow him to buy a house in Bombay.
That's so sweet. And let's go back to Zero. You know, working with someone like Shah Rukh is always a sort of double-edged sword, right? Because every director wants to work with him.
Right.
But when you work with him, there is the myth of a 25-year-old legacy of a superstar that you do have to serve and yet retain your own voice. And I don't know, my sense was that directors like Amol Palekar with Paheli or Manish Sharma with Fan were not able to walk that tightrope. It is a tightrope. Was it a struggle for you?
No, it wasn't. I think I'll give that entire credit to Khan sir for this, because I never met that star. He just
submitted sort, completely.
I won't say submitted. It was. Somebody asked me a few days back that how was it working with this superstar. I said, I have yet to meet him. I have yet to meet the superstar. The best part that happened with me, that before starting the film, 10 months we were just together. So when I took my first shot, purely that actor was there with me. The clean, pure actor. Without any stardom, he was there with me. So from the word go, when we started, he was a friend, he was a philosopher, he was guide, he was a family member, he was a student. So there was nothing like, and it's tough for him to do that. Yeah. But he did it. And that's the reason I can say that it's 100% pure film. There is no hangover, there is no stardom, there is no pretense. And this was the basic requirement for Zero. And I think we have been able to attain that purity.
So within the film itself also, you were never worried that, you know, how will his fans respond to, if he's too frail, if he's, you know, if we don't have the larger than life. I mean, he's really not larger, he's smaller than life.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. Did you ever worry about that?
I really trust the audience a lot. And I believe it, that we at times we read them in a very wrong way. It's they actually search for, they are not searching for, like even if we talk about Shah Rukh, they are not searching for the larger than life experience from. They are searching for that persona, that star which they had fallen in love with. I think I'm bringing that back to my audience. That approachable guy who was there with Raju Ban Gaya Gentleman and Yes Boss, and
he always felt like a part of the family.
Yeah. And I think Zero is his circle.
So, Anand, of course, now we're talking about the Anand Rai genre. But when you started making movies, you had two flops in a row.
Yes.
And at that time, when you made Strangers, when you made the second film, how did you sort of keep the faith in yourself when it didn't work? And you were a successful television director.
Yeah. But I understood what went wrong. I was never frustrated in saying ki yaar mujhe koi nahi samajh paya aur meri kahaniya koi nahi samajh paya. I knew that I was at fault.
You were aware enough.
I was aware enough. Straight away, I was aware of one thing, that what I'm trying to do with this film is to impress people, and that's not my job. My job is to tell a story. So the extract from those failures was, you're a storyteller. You have to tell a story. So when I came with Anu Hits Manu, I was strong as a storyteller. I was not sure whether it will work for me at box office, but my intentions were right of coming there and telling a story. I remember before starting Tanu Hits Manu, I told my wife that after this film, we'll have a lot of money. One, if it is successful, surely. And if it is not, I'll do so much of television that I'll get a lot of money for you.
You'll be rich anyway.
You're richer anyway. So enjoy.
It's all win-win.
Yeah, it was. And then I think that what I really learned was staying honest to your story and being fearless while telling your story. And then I caught on to it. Tanu Hits Manu gave me that confidence saying, just move ahead and tell your stories.
But Anand, one of the most dangerous things about success in the film industry is that you start to lose your connect with what made you successful in the first place, right? Ki aap bhool jate hain ki kahan se aaye, kya hua. Because slowly, slowly you just get cut off. You know, layers increase, ho jate, assistants, ADs become more, entourage becomes more. How do you resist that?
When you're asking, I can sense this, that it is a tough job.
It is tough.
It is a tough job. But for somebody like me, staying rooted and staying in that family zone is very important. That's one reason that even my production house, today where I'm working, it never gives you a feel of a studio where the films have been made, or a production house where there are blocks ki yahan pe ek aisi film banegi. I see to it that meri duniya middle class hi rahe.
Ghar jaisa.
Ghar jaisa. Till now I have managed. I don't know what will happen next. But whether it is my shooting floors or my office, I've kept my atmosphere where I belong, very middle class, happy, somewhere keeping yourself away from those materialistic things. I have managed till now. So I'm really conscious about it. Yeah. I really take care of it, that I don't hurt anybody. On the contrary, I have gone more conscious and more in control of things and saying ki ye duniya mat chhodna. I think this is what we are all about. Just stay, keep this world around you intact, like it is.
I read that you're very particular about the food in your office and the chai in your office. Ye kya hai?
Nahi, ye sirf wohi hai. This is bonding. This is nothing else. Eating together is something I always feel that it's the beginning of a good times ahead. So I see to it that whether it's in the family or in my office or on the set, we all eat together and bond on that.
And you know, Prasanna, who directed Shubhmangal Sadhan, said ki, you really love people. And he said, and that's why you are able to have such lovely characters in your films, because you love people. Is that true?
I'll tell you, till the age of 20, 21, I was a very shy person. I never used to talk to people. मतलब घर पे भी अगर मेहमान आते थे तो मैं नमस्ते कहने के लिए लाया जाता था और मैं नमस्ते बोल के चला जाता था. But then after my engineering and all, I think after that I started enjoying listening to people a lot. और by grace of God, when I sit with people, I somehow get lot of positive energies. मुझे हमेशा लगता है कि I am a very fortunate and blessed person. I always get my share of love. So, और मुझे अभी तक अपनी लाइफ में अच्छे लोग ही मिले. तो मेरे साथ होता यही है. So then falling in love is so obvious, no? When you are getting your share of love from everybody, then you will fall in love.
And that's what shows in your cinema as well.
Yeah, that's somewhere. It's my villains are not villains.
Yeah, somehow I can't even imagine you creating a villain.
नहीं होता हूँ.
नहीं ना. अंदर से निकलेगा ही नहीं.
निकलेगा ही नहीं. निकलेगा ही नहीं.
वो कहीं अच्छा ही बंदा या बंदी होगी.
हाँ, मतलब वो मुझे नहीं लगता कि villains होते हैं life में.
People are bad.
Situation, circumstances.
Yeah. And what do you want now as a director, Anand? What do you hope for? What do you aspire to?
Taking newer challenges, going for something what people are not expecting from you, only because of one thing, that I always felt that when you're successful, that's the time to contribute. Till then you are just fighting hard to survive. And now once you achieve something, this is the time to go ahead and contribute to that cinema which is feeding you, you know. So I will, and it's my job to do some commercial experiments also in future, and try for the films which are otherwise hum log apne cinema mein nahi dekh rahe. So I will keep on fighting till I do something jahan pe bola ja sake ki haan yahan se kuch contribution aaya hai.
Lovely, and I can't wait to see Zero. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hi, if you like this video, please subscribe to Film Companion.